Yes? Animal hair. I'll put it under the microscope for you so you can identify the species.
The paintbrush hair matches what we collected from the portrait. We're getting somewhere.
That's ready for image enhancement and microscopy. My kind of evidence. Wish some guy would draw a portrait of me like this. Flattering and so romantic. Way more romantic than severed limbs and alligator guts, don't you think?
Nope, I hate that sport. If you can call it one, that is.
Then maybe you just like to caddy.
If they're not around here, then Russ must have lugged them along to Louisiana.
What if we told you that they're not around here, or in Louisiana?
Hey, there's nothing more I can tell you about that.
That's all the questions we have for now.
All right, but I trust this is confidential. It's not something I like to advertise. I have a position at the club that commands a certain respect. I'm a manager and an athlete, and I have a certain image to maintain that doesn't go along with having a wife who sleeps around. How much of a man could I be if I'm not satisfying my woman? How much? That's what people think. What I think they think anyway. Is it a crime to be discreet? To choose not to air your dirty laundry? I'll deal with this in my own way. That's overstating it. Wasn't like that at all. Oh, I lost it all right. Told Tim and Ronnie what I thought of them. But it didn't quite come to serious blows or anything. She sees it from her end of the telescope. I see it from mine. Why not check with somebody impartial who witnessed the thing? Like Judge Lawford.
That's all the questions we have for now.
What do you need?
Russ never made it to that football camp. I'm in touch with Louisiana authorities and hope to track him down. Otherwise, he may well be our victim.
Yes, he's a sweet, gentle boy. An unusual combination of athlete and artist. Funny thing is, I misjudged him. I thought he was just another bonehead jock, and I detested that shallow mother of his, and I couldn't stand the thought of my Jessica being with him. So I made a kind of sacrifice. I was doing it for my daughter. And then the poor young fool started talking about loving me, and he drew that lovely portrait, and I just felt terrible about the whole affair. Would you like to hear a sad story? Not long ago, Ty told me he'd be working late. What he was really doing was arranging a romantic evening for us at a local hotel. He came home much earlier than expected, holding an armful of roses for me. Me? I was holding Russ. Funny thing is, he didn't get mad. All the blood drained out of his face, his eyes looked dead. He just swallowed and backed out of the bedroom and disappeared for a while. It wasn't until later at the club that he lost it and punched him out. That's when I knew I still loved Ty. After all these years, suddenly, he's my champion again. And I didn't even deserve it.
I knew after that public display of theirs at the Glen. Ronnie's lucky my son is 18, or I'd have you people on that round-heeled whore for statutory rape. If Ronnie Landon killed my husband, and I would not be surprised if she did, she should rot in jail, and then rot in hell.
That's all the questions we have for now.
Don't you mean Ty, Tim, Jessica, and Russ?
All four were involved? You didn't say that before.
Where young people are concerned, I tend to be, shall we say, judicious about what I say. It seems Russ has been spending an unusual amount of time with Ronnie.
You mean Russ's father has been spending time with Ronnie?
No, I am not senile, Ms. Duquesne. I said what I meant. My lord, the things people do to each other. Even in all my years, I am still able to be surprised by the casual depths of human cruelty. If you insist, I'll fill in the details as best I can. First, I have to say that to me, Palm Glen is a family. Dysfunctional, I will grant you, but a family. And I care about all these people. I don't want you getting the wrong idea about me. I'm not just some old busybody, but I do try to provide counsel and support. Anyway, young Russ and Jessica were sitting at a table at the club, and they weren't getting along. It was getting loud and out of hand. Finally, it simply exploded, with the two young people on their feet, in each other's faces, screaming. Soon, everyone present realized that Jessica knew her mother had been sleeping with Russ. And then, suddenly, the boy's father, Tim, added himself to the mix, really going off on the girl. You would think he'd be upset with his son, but instead he turned his fury on that poor child, Jessica, calling her a slut like her mother. The girl, to her credit, stood up to him, and the boy's father did something unspeakable. He grabbed the girl and shook her. Suddenly, Ty was in the room, and he rushed over and knocked Tim down. Ronnie witnessed it all, though she wasn't in the thick of it. I tell you, it was a horror show. Violence, emotion, sex. I'm sure some club members were thrilled. I was sickened. Ty's an athlete. He knocked Tim down. I'd be surprised if Tim's nose didn't get broken. Both Ty and Tim were out of control. Ty threatened to kill both father and son. But whether it was a real threat or bravado, that I can't judge. For that matter, Tim grabbed Jessica by the wrists and called her a... forgive this quote. A slut, just like your mother. Quite a scene, really.
That's all the questions we have for now.
Can I help you out in this case? Let me get this straight. Jessica's boyfriend, Ross, is seduced by Jessica's own mother, Ronnie? And Tim, the boyfriend's father, gets abusive with Jessica. Both Tim and Russ are missing and are linked to the severed arm. That's some major involvement for a minor. I'll contact her mother and make it happen.
I don't know. Forever? Last week? It's not the kind of thing you mark down in your day planner, you know. I mean, it's like devastating. When Mom cheats on Dad... she cheats on me. On all of us. The whole family. If funny. He's usually really easy to talk to. He's cool for a dad. But whenever I tried to, like, bring up my suspicions, he would just ignore it, pretend he didn't even know what I was talking about. Not till that night at the Palm Glen, when he dumped me for my own mother. Do you know how that made me feel? To have the two people I love most in my life betray me like that. What was up with Russ anyway? Is he like some kind of sick pervert or something? I mean, my mother? She's so old. Why are you asking me? I don't know.
That's all the questions we have for now.
Good call. So Ronnie's sleeping with both Coleman, and Ty is threatening to kill them both. Let's poke around some more in the Landon garage.